Hello YouTube and welcome to another bit of Minecraft. As you can probably recognize, this is the house that I built in the YouTuberverse. This is a copy. But on the subject of this video is this, which is this train station. Now, as I mentioned in the vlog 22, there were a load of chests in here that I had to get out. So I shifted them. I went on to schematics, and this building over here is a schematic from Nefashu. This one is called Green Light. There's going to be a link in the hoo-ha bar to a load of things. It's quite a nice modern building. I've obviously had to put some extra lighting in here because we have got mobs in the area and mobs active. You've got to watch when you place it because it does go down. So in order to get this level with the scenery, you probably have to go down a bit because it's going to go down as a result of here. Now, it's got a very nice area under here where mobs like to hide. And I've also put in a proximity door here. I've called it Doss's Place because that's where all the chests are located. That appears and disappears to let you through. A bit more light in here, that doesn't seem to go anywhere. Half bricks and all sorts. Again, I had to build some chandeliers in because of the lack of light. There was a lot of mob spawning in here. Very nice, clean textures, unfortunately made of wool, so you've got to watch what you're doing. Nice open spaces. What happened here? There were some chandeliers in here at one point. I don't know what's happened. I'm going to have to put those back. But yep, you can see all the extra lighting, bits and pieces, and yeah, they're all the chests with Doss's stuff in. So yeah, I don't know what happened to the ceiling lighting. I'm definitely going to have to put that back. I haven't got a clue what happened. So we're going to go back out of here. At least those ones are intact, and that's roughly what my simple design of chandeliers looked like in order to just even attempt to blend in. But I've had to put glowstone all over the place to prevent spawn. Right, so now we're going to go to the terminus itself, and to get in we have to get through this part. A lot of these tracks are glassed off to prevent any spawn getting in and anything just wandering in from outside. This is the ticket office, by the way. Now, I've done a number of things here. We have the seven tracks here. Mountain Tower, which I showed you before in a tour, and the Cafe of Death, which I've just put in. You can see that's selected. Various bits and pieces. There's track number A, which goes off and back that direction, because that's where it is. Number two, Cafe of Death down there, will be following that track momentarily. But this is what I've done on this. There's an area under this chest. All tracks come into here and throw off here, and anything gets put in this chest here. Minecart. The last minecart is in there. Now, obviously, that minecart is going to get full because we're never pulling from it, but it's defined as an area and saved as an area, which means that at any point we can actually recall that area and it will be replaced by an empty chest. That, to a degree, is what's happening behind the scenes here. If I just... how am I going to do this? Make myself a little entrance. That's what's happening here. You'll see that these signs, for their own... once they've triggered their own area, their own lines, they go back and trigger rail E chest. Rail empty chest. So no matter any time that anyone selects one of these, it automatically replaces the chest with an empty chest, which I thought was quite smart. And also, it also happens on the call button. And the call button is working in a pretty fancy way. I'm just going to knock a hole in here and another hole in here, because this is, again, wasted space. When the person presses the call button, a number of things happen. First of all, it does actually call... calls the chest cart, which then goes out to the user. It then the signal splits here. One goes up to operate this sign, which is just replacing the chest with nothing, and it also goes down here Now, when it goes down here, it's going down to a very interesting concoction of things. What's happening is the redstone signal is coming down, going around the corner and directly approaching this sign, which is an item dispenser, which dispenses the minecarts. Now, for this signal's got to be straight on. You can't approach this sign from the side, and you can't have redstone running across the front. It has to approach it directly. So this dispenses an item into midair. And this one, MC0209, collects it out of midair and puts it in the chest. So we have a permanent method that whenever anyone is actually calling a minecart, it automatically generates a minecart and puts one in the chest, which I thought was quite a nice, neat way of doing it. So that was one way of making it all happen. And we'll just block all this block back up again. Yep, come out of there. Ba-bum. So the system can never run out of minecarts. And whenever the call button gets pressed, or whenever anybody selects a different destination, the build-up of minecarts gets cleared. So we're never running out of minecarts. And that's how it happens. We call, and we get in, and we launch. Now we're launching through a glass section with, as you can see, one high, just to help ensure that nothing stray gets in. All these runs are encased by glass, by the way. So in theory, nothing should get in, but you never know. Better safe than sorry. This is a fairly long run out into the middle of nowhere, because eventually it does go out into the sea. Not very far, but I've got to say, Nefashu's Modern Cafe, entitled Nefa's Modern Cafe, is quite a large structure. But, and it's night, so with a bit of luck, we'll see a bit of fighting going on. The craft book mod for minecarts does mean that minecarts can run and just glide on a horizontal surface, but I put these extra boosters in because I have seen that it does have a tendency to slow down. Where's that area? That area where you can see the light. There's the cafe coming into scene. And that area of light there that was just passing, we'll come back to that in a bit. But here we are, ready to do battle. Boomf. This again is a straightforward system. Again, we've got the cart generator under there. So if someone's coming and there's no carts, and the dispenser dispenses no carts, all they've got to do is press the call button again, and a cart will pop into existence. The one thing that this setup doesn't have is the automatic destruction of carts. So if the chest under there does get full, then someone will come off, and they'll just come off the end of the rails, and they'll have to destroy the cart themselves. But here is the cafe, and as you can see, it's very dark. I've put some extra lighting in the courtyard to help stop any unwelcome visitors being here when you step off the train. There's two entrances, one here and one around the side. We're game mode one, so nothing's going to attack us, but it would attack anyone else. Nefashu's made great use of half bricks here. You can see that's actually we're actually walking on half bricks. That's a full height of wool and more half on top of there. Very good use. This is the other entrance, and if you walk in, automatically, more automatic doors for you. Now, as you can see, it's very dark, so things are going to spawn in here. Who knows what? So you can have a nice punch up in here with whatever's there. There's a zombie over there in the distance. Two zombies, in fact. Three zombies. So you can have a nice punch up here. You can blow things up. Come on. there's actually a kitchen area back here. Can we get into it from here? No. We've got to get into it from back here. nice and dark for you, so you could get pounced on by anything. The zombies will pound on the doors, all the rest of it. There's the kitchens. Lots of closed, tight areas. Whoops. Yep, there's a creeper. Let's have a bash at him. Boom. Boom. Oh dear, we've blown a hole in things. There's another one. Ah! Boom. Who cares? we'll make our way up as best we can to the upper sections. More half bricks. Very dark. Anything could crop up on us anyway. Creepers being green will just meld into this lot, and won't know until you've hit one. Something's up here because I can hear something. Also, I've just had the sound to say that there's actually an abandoned mineshaft beneath us. So that just adds to the spookiness. Not intentional, but yeah. So you get the idea. You're going to have a right bust up here. Again, we're in game mode 1. Oh! Wouldn't have seen him until he'd shot me. There you go. More stairs. We didn't come up these. We can, yeah. I can hear zombies. You know, you can have a good old mooch. It's just a great environment to basically... Let's say we have a punch-up in the foyer. Bang, 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 boosh. All the rest of that jazz. Yeah, really busted up. All we've got to do is go down here. Into here. This is the cafe reset button. You just push that button and it resets the cafe. There you go. Nice new foyer, just as if nothing had ever happened. It's reset the whole building. So you can have a right royal punch up in here and nothing will come of it. How did I get into that other section at the back? I'm probably going to have to go up here and then down the other set of stairs. But, yep, down this set of stairs. And there we are, there's the stairs which we blew up and made our own way up when we came out of the kitchen. Blew all this up and everything's intact. In fact, you can still see the despawned items that got blown up from the from the accident, shall we say. Oh, come on, Mr. Creeper, this is a kitchen. Don't you know anything about food hygiene? Obviously not. Oh, there's another one. Ah! Oh dear. Oh, come on. Where are you going? Come here. Come here. My keyboard's stuck. Oh dear. Oh, and the best bit about it, oh, you got a hello, Ender Pratt. Come on. Where are you? Oh, I see. You were waiting to ambush people as they came in, weren't you? Sneaky git. Another. Come on, creeper. Over here. Here, creepy. Gotcha. You can have a good bit of fun in here. Another creeper. Boom. Oh, good grief. You can have a good bit of fun in there. And then at the end of the day, just hit the button. Obviously, you're going to need an admin to reboot the button. Otherwise, you're going to do a lot of swimming. And there you go, it's all brand new again. Obviously, this is this quick because I am this close to the server. Otherwise, it would probably have to reload some chunks for anyone who's not on the server. Ooh, what do you think you're doing? Fiddler on the roof? If I were a rich skell. Hee goodbye. And yeah, there you go. Cafe Death. Thank you very much, Nafashu. You're probably not listening to this, but thank you for coming up with these schematics. They are great. Loving them. Call. Oh, there's nothing in there. Ah, there's nothing in there because we've just actually reloaded the area. And indeed, there's actually no minecarts coming up. Why not? Probably because I didn't neglect it to resave the area, and there's probably nothing under there. Yep, I didn't neglect it to resave the area, and I've got to redo this. Oh, an admin's job is never done. Okay, YouTube, take it easy, and I'll see you on the next video. Bye.